الله محمد رسول الله محمد رسول الله أرجو رضاك يا الله أنت الرحيم يا الله هبني عطاك يا الله أنت الكريم منك العطاء يا الله أنت العظيم يا فيك الرجاء يا الله أنت الحليم.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. My dear respected brothers and sisters, علماء, مشايخ, دعاة, all of you brothers and sisters, alhamdulillah. Our next lecture is about to begin, and I just want to say that the topic of this lecture is one which is close to my own heart, the message of peace, the message of salam, the foundations of Islam. If you consider that in a period after the death of that greatest man that's ever walked this earth, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a period of around 80 years, the Quran, the message of peace, with no internet, with no extranets, with no satellite technology, with no jumbo jets, with no planes, with no cars, with no motors, subhanAllah, with no smartphones or iPhones and your phones, it went from Portugal to China in a period of 80 years, a message of peace, the Quran, and it was unchallenged, it was unmatched, it was unrivaled. And this message, it went on the back of a horse with a piece of parchment. But the reality is that the people that were carrying that message were diamonds. The lecture the Sheikh will address today, subhanAllah, is one of the Quran being the thing that shook the world and changed the world, subhanAllah, with peace. Sheikh Muhammad Saleh is one of the most well-known Islamic scholars and thinkers from the USA, who now resides in Egypt. He has an MBA in Islamic studies from Coverdale College, Theological Foundations, Indiana, USA. He obtained his BA in Sharia and Islamic law from the University of Al-Azhar in Egypt, and a BA in pharmacology, and was also an assistant professor of pharmacology. He obtained a 4-year diploma in Muslim arts and Arabic calligraphy. He's led Islamic centers in Victoria, Texas, and founded two Islamic and Arabic schools, namely Iman Stems and the Muslim Generation. He is a persistent host of Ask Huda and Correct Your Recitation, I could do with that as well, which are among the most well-known programs on the Huda TV channel. He's a religious supervisor of Huda TV as well, and has well over 500 live broadcasting hours in Arabic and American television stations. He's the instructor of Sharia Academy USA and teaches at the London College Online. And his message today will be, as I've mentioned before, Al-Quran, the message of peace. Without further delay, we invite to the stage the Honorable Sheikh and teacher Muhammad Saleh. Assalamu alaikum. Sheikh Muhammad Saleh, come forward.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله وكفى وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى، لا سيما المصطفى صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. All praise due to Allah alone. We praise Him and we seek His help. Whomsoever Allah guides is the truly guided one. And whosoever Allah leaves astray, none can show him guidance. May the best peace and blessings be upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Dear brothers and sisters, indeed, it's an honor and pleasure to stand before you right now and share with you some of the beautiful words and teachings of Allah in the most glorious book, Al-Quran Al-Kareem. But before that, I would like to share with you the very good news. Since the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam instructed us saying, Bashiru wa la tunaffiru, give glad tidings, make people rejoice. Right before Jumu'ah prayer, by the grace of Allah, Brother Alexander, son of the Dutch politician Arnold van Doorn, have accepted Islam. Alhamdulillah, today Jumu'ah prayer was the very first prayer that he offered. Everybody was in tears. His father was exceedingly happy. And this is all by the grace and the blessings of Allah the Almighty. So we should constantly invoke Allah as saying, Allahumma ahdina wa ahdi bina waj'alna sababan liman ihtada. O Allah, guide us and cause us to be guidance for others. Ameen. The Quran, the message of peace. Where to begin from? I must begin by defining the Quran. What is the Quran? كلام الله تعالى المنزل على عبده محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم المتعبد بتلاوته. It is the blessed word of Allah the Most High, which He has sent down upon His last messenger Muhammad, peace be upon him. So the source is Allah, who's the source of peace and the giver of peace. One of His beautiful names is As-Salam, one who's free from any imperfection and deficiency. And He is the only source of peace, and He is the ultimate giver of peace. So no wonder if His message to everything that exists is full of peace. In the Quran, brothers and sisters, the word As-Salam and its derivatives was mentioned in 140 passages. The direct mention of the word As-Salam and its derivatives in the noun and the verb form, 140 times it was mentioned in the Quran. And that word, which means peace, its meaning revolves around six main meanings have been mentioned in the Quran. The first, as one of the beautiful names of Allah the Almighty, As-Salam. Surah Al-Hash, Allah the Almighty says in ayah number 23, وَاللَّهُ الَّذِي لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ الْمَلِكُ الْقُدُّوسُ السَّلَامُ الْمُؤْمِنُ الْمُهَيْمِنُ السَّلَامُ الْمُؤْمِنُ الْمُهَيْمِنُ الْعَزِيزُ الْجَبَّارُ الْمُتَكَبِّرُ سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ عَمَّا يُشْرِكُونَ. He is Allah, besides whom none has the right to be worshipped. He's the King, He's the Holy, He's As-Salam. He is the source of peace and the giver of peace. He is the only one who's free from any imperfection and deficiencies. As-Salam is also mentioned in the Quran as the name of that religion. And it is not a coincidence that one of the names of Allah is As-Salam, and his message is a message of peace in the Quran. And that Quran was revealed on a night which is described as Salam. In Surah Al-Qadr, Allah the Almighty says, Inna anzalnahu fi laylatil qadr wa ma adraka ma laylatul qadr laylatul qadri khayrun min alf shahr tanazzalul malaikatu war ruhu fiha bi idhni rabbihim min kulli amr سلام هي حتى مطلع الفجر. On the night of the revelation of the Quran, which is Laylatul Qadr, it is described in the surah as a peaceful night, a night that is full of peace more than any other night, a night which is better than 1,000 months of continuous worship, because the Quran was revealed on that night. سلام هي حتى مطلع الفجر.
What rights and responsibilities do relatives have on each other? Are we required by Sharia to spend on our kins? What can you do if your kins are severing ties with you? What rights do non-Muslims have on their Muslim relatives? This is Ahmed ibn Saifuddin asking you to be with me when I discuss these issues and more in my series, Kins, Rights and Responsibilities, here on Peace TV.
Appreciate the vision of Islam that has put the provisions to ensure the sustainability of strong intimacy amongst relatives in Kin's Rights and Responsibilities. Every Monday at 7 p.m. and repeat telecast at 12 p.m. India on Peace TV.
This is your brother Salim Al-Amiri. You're watching Peace TV, the solution for humanity.
A friendly message by Dr. Zakir. Old age home.
Al-Quran, Surah Al-Isra, chapter number 17, verses number 23 and 24 says, Your Lord has decreed that you worship none but Him, and that you be kind to parents. Whether one or both of them attain old age in your life, say not a word of contempt. Do not say oof to them, nor repel them, but address them in terms of honor. And out of kindness, lower to them the wing of humility and say, My Lord, bestow on them your mercy, even as they cherished me in childhood. There is no place for old age home in Islam.
Peace TV, the solution for humanity.
Our topic, which is of Qawaid al-Fiqhiyyah, Fiqhi rules, legal maxims.
Reasons sensible, motives justified, references relevant.
What we're studying is a qawaid al-fiqhiyyah. We need to know the benefit of studying it.
The practical applications of Islamic laws are impeccable.
What about rules of fiqh, qawaid al-fiqhiyyah, derived from the Quran and Sunnah?
Qasim al-Hakim.
Five main rules in a qawaid al-fiqhiyyah.
Explore the evidences that prove the reformative and preventive aspects of Islamic laws in Al-Qawaid Al-Fiqhiyyah, next on Peace TV.
I'm a Muslim for all of time.
that he chose that name for the only true religion which he accepts and approves. He says, Azza wa Jalla in Surah Al-Imran, إِنَّ الدِّينَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ الْإِسْلَامِ. Most surely, the only true religion with Allah is Islam. Then in the same chapter, Allah the Almighty says, وَمَنْ يَبْتَغِ غَيْرَ الْإِسْلَامِ دِينًا فَلَنْ يُقْبَلَ مِنْهِ وَهُوَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. And whoever desires and seeks other than Islam as a religion, it won't be accepted from him. So if there is only one God, then there is only one message, and there is only one religion. And it is no secret that Allah the Almighty said that the only religion which he approves is Islam, is to submit yourself sincerely and entirely unto him. And whosoever takes, seeks, desires other than Islam as a religion, it would not be accepted from him by Allah. Rather, on the Day of Judgment, he will be from among the losers. And I believe that is the right and a straightforward answer to a question which I may receive after the session, which was asked last night. What if I believe in Muhammad as a messenger of Allah, but I still do not declare that? I do not accept Islam. What is going to happen to me? Allah the Almighty says, what's going to happen? It won't be accepted from him, and he will count amongst the losers. May Allah protect all of us and guide us to his straight path. The following meaning of the word salam in the Quran is a greeting. And it is indeed the greeting of the only religion which has been taught to Adam, peace be upon him, in heaven by the angels, and instructed to the believers in the Quran. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam commanded us to spread the word of peace. He said, by Allah, you shall not believe not until you love one another. And you would not love one another until you spread the greeting of peace. Or shall I not guide you to something that if you do, you would love one another? He said, certainly, O Prophet of Allah. He said, Afshu salama baynakum. Spread the greeting of peace amongst you. Abdullah ibn Salam, may Allah be pleased with him, who was a former Jewish rabbi, he said, I visited Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, amongst the first batch of people who received him as an immigrant. The very first few words I heard from him, Ayyuhan nas, afshu salam. O people, spread peace, spread the greeting of peace. Wa at'imu at'am, wa sallu bil layli wan nas niyam, tadkhulu jannata rabbikum bi salam. In Surah Al-An'am, what a beautiful verse. Verse number 54, Allah the Almighty says, وَإِذَا جَاءَكَ الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِآيَاتِنَا فَقُلْ سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ كَتَبَ رَبُّكُمْ عَلَى نَفْسِهِ الرَّحْمَةِ أَنَّهُ مَنْ عَمِلَ مِنْكُمْ سُوءًا بِجَهَالَةٍ ثم تاب من بعده وأصلح فأنه غفور رحيم. Which means, whenever those who believe in our commandments come to you, O Muhammad, peace be upon him, فقل سلام عليكم. Say to them, peace be upon you. Your Lord has ordained mercy upon himself. So if any of you does evil in ignorance, then he turns afterward with repentance and does a right. وَأَصْلَحَ Indeed, Allah will be all forgiving and most merciful. This is a message of peace and assurance. So long as you turn to Allah with sincere repentance and beg for His forgiveness, most certainly you will be forgiven. And that gives us peace. That gives us comfort and peace of mind. And the greatest ayah with regards to hope lies in Surah Az-Zumar, in which Allah the Almighty addresses the worst type of sinners, calling them by saying, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. Say, O Muhammad, peace be upon him, to my servants who have transgressed against themselves. They've done all type of sins, all sort of disobedience. Despair not of Allah's mercy, because Allah forgives all sins. He is all forgiving, the most merciful. You know, brothers and sisters, we were born, or most of us were born in Islam. But whom do we envy most? We envy those who accepted Islam today, yesterday, and who will continue to accept Islam today and tomorrow. Why? Because when Amr ibn al-As, one of the Meccan pagans, came to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam to accept Islam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam stretched out his hands in order to accept a pledge of allegiance from him. Amr ibn al-As pulled back his hand and said, not before you promise me. He said, promise you what? He said, I'm a big time sinner. I've done all the bad things. You gotta promise me that if I accept Islam, Allah will forgive me. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam smiled and said, oh Amr, don't you know that al-Islamu yajubbu ma qabla? Don't you know that Islam remits and wipes away all the sins which were committed before that moment? So those who declare the Shahada today are the luckiest, are newborn, in a sense that all their bad deeds have been forgiven, yet their good righteous deeds which they've done even before Islam are still stated, and they will be, inshallah, rewarded for them. The fourth meaning of the word salam in the Quran is safety and security against every evil. Allah the Almighty instructed Prophet Hud, peace be upon him, upon getting ready to land. In Surah Hud, in ayah number 48, Allah instructed Prophet Nuh, peace be upon him, saying, قِيلَ يَا نُوحُ اهْبِطْ بِسَلَامٍ مِنَّا وَبَرَكَاتٍ عَلَيْكَ وَعَلَىٰ أُمَمٍ مِّمَّنْ مَعَكَ. Allah said to him, descend with peace and blessings from us upon you and upon the people from amongst the nations who were with you. The fifth meaning, as I mentioned earlier, the word salam revolves in the Quran around six main meanings. The fifth is an admiration. Thana, Surah As-Saffat, Allah admired several of his prophets. He began by Prophet Nuh, peace be upon him, in ayah number 79. He said, Salamun ala Nuhin fil alameen. And similarly, he said, Salamun ala Ibrahim, Salamun ala Musa wa Harun, Salamun ala Ilyasin, which means peace from us be upon Nuh. In the world, upon Ibrahim, upon Moses and Aaron, upon Prophet Ilyas, peace be upon all of them. And the sixth meaning of the word salam in the Quran means goodness, righteousness, good speech. In Surah Al-Furqan, Allah the Almighty admired the servants of the most beneficent. Amongst their traits, he said, Azza wa Jal, وَالَّذِينَ يَمْشُونَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ هَوْنًا وَإِذَا خَاطَبَهُمُ الْجَاهِلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامًا.
He created the universe.